easy to find a game. Well, do you guys want to see a game?
Yeah, I'd love to see a game.
Let's look at a game.
Sure.
So this is a tournament game I just played very recently. This is the online Go Creators Invitational 2015 tournament, which I think you can find at peanutgo.com or .org, peanutgo.org. Or if you just Google Go Creators Invitational Peanut Go, I'm pretty sure you'll find it. So it's 32 basically people who do Go stuff on the internet is probably what it should be called. And so it's got some pretty well-known people in it, and if you watch any sort of like Go resources on the internet or online, you probably know half the people in the tournament. So it's kind of fun to watch just for that reason. This is my game against Mr. Handy, who's a pretty strong European player, I think. I think he's from Germany, but I could be wrong. You can just Google Mr. Handy on YouTube and find some games that he's played and check him out.
H-A-N-D-I-H-O-N-D-I?
It's Mr. M-R-H-A-A-N-D-I. Two A's. Mr. Handy.
Denmark?
Is that Denmark? It sounds Dutch, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I saw his flag somewhere along the way, and it had a German flag, so I'm not sure. I don't know. I don't watch enough. Maybe you know, people out there who are watching this right now all know his channel, and can actually leave a comment and correct me, because that's what they do on the internet. They just leave comments when I get stuff wrong. So I'm black in this game. These are all even games in the tournament. And officially, I'm part of Group D. I think there's eight groups.
Is it the US Open or something?
No, this is online Go Creators Invitational. And I play this opening. What is this called?
What team is Orthodox? Your team?
No teams.
Orthodox.
Yes, very good. And so white deals with it in the more traditional way. Again, this is more normal now, perhaps, but not by a lot. Both of these are fine. And my first real problem with the game is, now what does black do?
I cry,
hide underneath the table.
I would push the white stone.
Which direction?
Push. I don't know. Push your opponent in the direction.
Yeah, I actually don't want to push the white stone here.
Oh, okay.
Because I don't know which direction I want to push it in yet.
I don't want him.
So I want to try to figure out which direction I want to push it before I push it. Does that make sense? So we're going to go and start asking some questions. And white plays a very strange move. Why is it strange?
Because it's not really a pincer.
It's not really a pincer.
And it's not really a shimari.
Yeah, it's not.
It's an extension, though.
Yeah, it's, well, sort of. But we like to make 5-space extensions, right? So this is effectively a 6-space extension from both stones. And we don't like 6-space extensions because that's big enough for your opponent to make a base, right? 2-space base in there. So we don't usually like to play this kind of move. So I kind of treated him like he was passing, is what I said. I said, oh, you passed. Good. So I came over here and counter-pincered the corner. Which I have no idea if I still kind of feel okay about this, although I think white can get a fairly decent result. I mean, in the game it ended up being a decent result for both players. Like, it wasn't, out of the question. But it was certainly, I think, pretty reasonable.
So you won this game?
I'm not going to tell you, Dan. Alright. So we play this sort of thing. At this point, white really has two choices. I'm just trying to settle my stones in the corner and then go back to building stuff. White can extend here, or white can take this Atari. And, after the game, I reviewed a little bit with Dwyren, another popular commentator, and he was streaming the game on his Twitch channel live. He thinks white should have played this way, and this would be more solid, but I'm not actually so convinced. Like, I think white got an okay result the other way, too. So here's what Mr. Handy did in the game, was to play here. And of course, there's no way black is connecting, not a million years. So white is no interest in fighting a cove for the entire top left-hand corner of the board. Right, there's just no threats. White can't do this. That's just a bad idea. So white fills. This is a quasi-joseki. Black connects. white cuts. This cut's good because of this stone.
Yeah, somehow that funny looking room is looking a lot better now.
White smooth?
No, this one in the middle.
This one, yeah, this one looks good, right? So in the end, this worked out. This worked out for both players, I think. The problem is, black was actually able to develop the top in a big way. And there's actually still a lot of Aji here for black, right? Yeah, these two stones are still sort of being lost.
Black doesn't really have much of a hold on the top either. I mean, it's less going for him on the top than white has in that round.
Well, but there's more Aji here. And this is a wrong size extension. So, I don't know, Dan. I don't know.
We'll see.
We'll see. All right. All right, at this point, I'm pretty sure I pushed in the wrong direction.
Oops.
Which now I've learned something about the shape of this board, right? So now I'm ready to come back and play this side of the board. I think I do it wrong. But no one has told me I've done it wrong yet. This is just my own assumption.
Okay. Does that mean you lost the game?
Shh. So which way would you want to push this stone?
I would want to push it.
At this point,
we have hold. We'll take a show of hands. We have one vote for pushing it down. Anyone else want to share their?
I'll go down.
Dan wants to go down.
Up, but
Gideon wants to go up.
Towards the strength is good.
Towards the strength, so that's up.
Generally.
Okay.
Oh, that's also into your potential.
Okay. And was it Peter?
Peter, right.
Peter, yeah.
I haven't even looked at the board yet.
Oh, okay. Well, guess up or down, just for fun.
Left.
Left. Got it. In the game, I played here. But I think this is pretty viable, and perhaps even better. I kind of like this better. In retrospect.
How do you react?
Well, I played here.
Oh, you played there.
I played here. And you know, maybe I should play here too, just because it has better follow-ups. But I decided to play here and make up my own follow-up, which I kind of regret, but worked out for me, sort of. It's very, very interesting to see what happens in reasonably fast-timed tournament games. The other thing that happened during this game, that I was playing only my second game on the OGS server ever, and it only beeps the last 3 seconds of your Byo-Yomis, which I didn't realize. So, like, it would go beep, beep, beep. And I would play a move thinking, I would do it before. Like, I was thinking Byo-Yomi was at least 5 or 10 seconds, like, worth of beeping. And so I burned through 3 or 4 of my Byo-Yomis, like, really fast in this game. But I had no idea.
See.
So that was kind of a fun realization.
What was the period of the Byo-Yomi?
30 seconds. Not that we're in Byo-Yomi here at this part of the game, but I'm just saying, like, that part is coming up.
Are you allowed to have somebody with you to warn you if you're actually...
I don't think that was stipulated by the rules, so...
No, I'm just curious.
I don't know. I can't answer that question. So white plays here. And I would still kind of like to build this, right? I would like to build both here, and I'd like to develop this. Shh. You can't make moaning noises if you don't. So we play. Just try to force white low. If this stone was here, this would actually be a much stronger move. Right? This is the argument I mentioned earlier between playing this and this. If we play this one, there's a very, very standard Joseki kind of sequence here that looks something like this. And this would build the bottom in a pretty big, indirect way. Here, some pick a move. We'll say there. So this is pretty much a pretty set Joseki at this point.
Yeah, that's what we did a couple weeks ago in the two space extension.
Yeah. So I didn't do that. So it doesn't. I mean, it could still work, but in theory, white's probably going to not play out the sequence the same way. And besides, I was really trying to build that side. So I shoulder hit here. I'm pretty sure this move's wrong. I still think even in this case, if I'm going to shoulder hit, I should still shoulder hit this one, or play here, or even just come play down here. Like, I think I'm actually perfectly fine to leave this alone. But I forced the issue. because, you know, go and stuff. It's what players do.
Online.
Well, yeah, this is, I mean, it's an online tournament.
That's awesome.
So, again, here I'm expecting white to do this. And in which case, I can pull back and continue my thought process, but this is not the game. And so instead, white played here. And I think this move is okay. Like, I don't think this move is actually that bad for white. It's okay. What do you guys think? No idea? Well, what's white trying to do?
That's the part I have no idea about.
No idea?
Separate.
Push into the corner.
I think what white's really trying to do is, number one, get sente and prevent me from building this really easily. So, here, I'll show you the sequence. And I'll show you what it should look like. And at this point, white should just play here. Right. And now has a big follow-up in the corner here and can also get out.
Right.
But in the game, white played here. So this is actually a pretty big difference here. What's the difference?
Yeah, two cutting points.
Yeah, it leaves these cuts here, right? Now there's nothing, it doesn't work yet. But no cutting points, right? And it's almost the exact same. And you might even actually say that it actually invades the corner even stronger now, right? Because even if I get super strong here, you always have this move in sente. So this is better shape for reduction on the corner. Again, I think white is worried about this. So white is trying to say, hey, you need to like fix this, I can poke through. But it does leave defects. The shape is pretty terrible for white. Like we would say this is bad shape for white. Right, because you're leaving too many defects. That's what I'm saying, Dan.
You can understand why I did it.
Oh, you could totally understand the reasoning. My point is, like, this is much stronger shape, right? Now white is alive, no questions asked, no cuts, super safe.
Yeah, but you're.
And the next part of the game is real fun. So far everything we've done has been boring. So what does that mean?
Fight time.
Fight time.
Yes.
So how does white start the fight here? What does white want to fight over? Is there anything for white to fight over?
Not yet.
Wrong answer.
I'd say he wants to keep you separated if he could.
Yeah, we have this group of four stones, right? That aren't really connected to anything. And if they do get connected to something, let's say black gets a move in here or here, now they're really contributing to the development of this. So white wants to fight over this.
So would white play on 16 just above the black four there?
Here?
Yeah.
Okay, you're going to learn a new shape move, Gideon.
Okay.
This is the move that white really wants to play, but the shape is terrible.
Right.
It's even more terrible than before, right? Because now we have an empty triangle to boot with our connection problems.
Okay.
So in this case, especially when you really want to fight, you know, here, this, let's say black Hanes, you're gonna end up playing here, right? So what we're gonna do is just play that move instead.
Oh.
And this is more proper fighting technique. Gives you a lot more agi over here. Now the downside of this move in this case is that you'll run out of liberties down here very fast. And so this cut can become a thing again. But technically white's safe. I mean, white's still safe, so it's not. It's just the cuts are even bigger than they were before. So yes, if this is the sequence you read, if you want to push and you read that's for your opponent and you just want to play there, just play there.
Okay.
Right? Because look what happens. Black cuts, and this is the game. It's like when you played there, black cut in here and didn't have a choice about it. If you play here, black can actually just back off, right? And just continue to build the outside. And meanwhile, you need to come back and then maybe at some point play this shape. Do you know this shape?
B2 bomber.
The B2 bomber? Who are you bombing?
Yourself.
Yourself. Don't make the B2 bomber. So in this case, when you just jump out and make the same kind of shape, it actually basically forces your opponent to fill in the place that you really don't want to play. And if it's a good move for me, it's a good move for my opponent kind of thing. And if it's a bad move for me, it's a bad move for my opponent kind of thing. You know, it's not quite equivalent, but you know the idea, right? So this is indeed the game. And I can actually probably do this whole game from memory, but I'm going to make sure I keep up with it here just in case I mess up. And so now, lo and behold, we've got a real fight. Not a real fight? I think it's a real fight.
I want to be blue.
You want to be the blue player?
Yeah, I don't want to be black or white.
It's pretty scary. Right? Because white still has this Aji. This black group only has 3 liberties. This white group only has 3 liberties. This black group only has 2 liberties. It's a fight. I mean, this is why you play Go. Alright, so in the game, I extended, which I thought was very reasonable. And remember, I just wanted this, right? So how does this move help this?
Substantially.
Like, substantially. Like, not just getting 4th line territory, we're talking about getting 6th line territory here. So I'm pretty excited to play this. I kind of, in retrospect, want to play this. Because... you want to explore this one? What would you do here as white?
You have to enter an empty triangle if you want to save the 2.
Yeah, I think this cut is valuable. Because not only is it a cut, you also get an additional free move. That might be useful later on. And then I think it's empty triangle time. Sometimes you need to make the empty triangle in a fight, right? Because this is the key point to capture. And then also, if black doesn't respond locally, right, this sets up the ladder. And if white gets a nice strong group here, what happens to my hopes and dreams for this?
Dashed.
But I still kind of think I can play anyway. Now, I think the move I really want to play here is come here and try to take 7th line territory. I think it doesn't work without any other sort of preparations because white has this sort of netting move. Right? There's no way out. No way out for this net. Can't push.
I'm not sure those but, still
bad. I'm not sure. Well, we're in fantasy land. We're just exploring. But I think black can play this first. And I think this gets black the extra move
true.
To get out, right? So that, and I didn't see this in my read. This is why I didn't play this, is because I kind of forgot. At least I didn't see it yet. I see this sequence like after I play my next move, and then I regret everything and have nightmares. And I'll show you that.
So show us your nightmares?
A little bit.
Dark.
All right, we have Atari. It's not even Atari. Well, it still doesn't work, does it?
No.
Oh, no, it still doesn't work. Never mind.
Ha.
Then my nightmares were actually nightmares and not... All right, never mind. Still doesn't work. Never mind, that prep doesn't... Okay. Well, then I regret nothing. Because
no.
In the game...
Play.
I played here. I think I think that's a real safety move. Now the question is whether or not black can just capture these.
You white.
White. Great.
Oops,
hold on.
I mean, that's not possible.
Oh, wait, did I not? What? Oh, you know what? No, I think I did play here. Never mind. I remember the game wrong. Because in the comments, in the stream, we reviewed it afterward, too, and we looked at some of these things, and sometimes... Did this really happen? This really happened. Okay, never mind. Ooh, I am dreaming. Dunk, dunk. Oh, wait, yeah, this is the game. What am I talking about? Right, oh, and I played this now.
And it doesn't work.
No, it doesn't work. And this is the moment I realized so I had my plan, right? After I played this, I was like, oh, then I can come back and play this. And this is the moment where I realized, oh, it doesn't work.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Let's look if you...
push on the top, what happens?
I don't understand what you mean.
With your weak group, extend it. See what happens. Let him have that one stone.
This is the game.
Oh. Well, let's see.
But if I'm just going to push here, I shouldn't cut yet. Right, because number one, I'm actually not 100% sure which side I want to cut. And number two, let's say white just plays really conservative and fixes this defect. Well, later on, I can get sente moves over here. So this is a bad cut to take right now, because it resolves the shape too easily for white. But I did it, and then I realized that my extension doesn't work, so then I had to come back here and play another move anyway. So white extends. And now, here we go. Now we play this. Okay.
Yeah, you're looking okay. I mean, you have a pretty weak group.
This group is very weak.
Pretty weak, yeah.
Like, really weak. But what does black have?
Unclear.
It's unclear?
I don't know. It's right.
Wait a minute.
Is
this group?
This group?
No.
This one? Oh, very weak. He has a weak group too, right?
His group was like... He's got to move that group. Or, well, I can do that, sure.
I can do that. All right, at this point in the game, I have some regrets.
Actually, I don't...
And it has to do with this stone. Not me playing it, but now how I used it. Because I was thinking, the shape I'd really like to get is something like this. Because in my mind, you know, let's just say this worked somehow, right? Then my stone would be on his key point here, would be spoiling his shape. And for me, in my head, that would be like a really good result, right? If he has to come back and fix the shape, and I could do whatever I wanted. And so that's sort of what I was playing for. Except that I think this is better. What's the obvious weakness if I make this shape? What is white going to do immediately?
Push in? Yeah, we'll just peep.
Yeah, just peep right here, right? So, do I care about giving white this peep? I mean, it looks like it's really valuable, right? But I already have these two stones here, so it's kind of tricky to use right away. So in the game, I think I should have done this. I think I should. I shouldn't have been so scared just to give black this. I shouldn't have been trying so hard to have this stone ruin the shape. And instead, I should just let white do his thing, and that makes my group actually a lot stronger than in the game.
Is that what you played?
I went here.
That's what I would have done.
And the reason is because when white responds over here, I can come back over here and play that shape screwy business.
Oh,
right, because white plays here.
Right. Oh, so the other one was a line lower, wasn't it?
Yeah, and it's a pretty big difference in shape. It's a really big difference, right? I mean, when I play this one, it looks like I'm getting an eye here, and this stone is going to poke out the weak point in the white connection over here. Which is why I want to play this one. But the downside is it sort of gives white an extra move with this group. Whereas if I play this one...
Hold up. Yeah, so you played that. And then
I didn't play this.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I played this.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you have a question, Dan?
No.
Okay, good.
I want to see what happens.
Okay, good. Good talk. It was a good talk.
I think you're like too obsessed with getting that high on top of those.
I know, that's what I'm saying. This honey, right?
This one, yeah. You seem to...
I know, that's what I'm telling you my mistakes so you guys learn from them. I'm saying, look, I in my head, right, I'm reading all these moves in the tournament, right, and I read all these things where, like, white has to make a shape like this or like this.
Right.
This is stupid because I have a stone here, right? But I overvalued it. It turns out it's not that valuable, right? So... I'm telling you, I have regrets. And I wish, instead of trying to take advantage of this stone, I just let white have another free move. So that's my regret. But in the game, I played there, which gave white a free move here.
Yeah.
And now I'm coming back here. Well, yeah, because this is my plan, right? It's to spoil the shape.
Oh, okay.
But white takes another free move right here.
Yeah.
And do you guys like seventh line territory?
Yes.
Okay. That's the game.
It's not territory, though.
Well.
How close?
It's still so lucky.
White played here. Yeah.
He's not impressed by your 7-5 territory.
He's not.
Is that a serious move?
Well, how do you like this stone? Do you like this stone?
Not that much.
Okay, then where do you want to play, Dan?
I don't know. It looks like you're good to move. You can
turn.
Play lots of moves. Yeah.
Probably turn.
I mean, your Hoshi stone's pretty strong.
I don't think you're wrong. In the game, though, we want to fight over everything. So
too much online attitude.
Yeah, I mean, oh, you want to kill this stone? Oh, no, you didn't. And that's a little unfortunate because then white gets this move. This move hurts a lot. But, you know, I said, hey, I can make an eye. That's good, right? This is not a real eye, people. White, it's as long as white has liberties in this group, right, white can always spoil this eye. So, not a real eye. So white pushes again. Again, I ask you, do you guys like 7th line territory?
Of course.
Of course. I hate it. Let's keep the gravy train going.
I don't know what to do with all those free points. It's just...
I know, at this point, I was like, I won this game.
We're not.
That's what I said. I was like, I won this game. Look, I even saved this corner. I have 7th line territory. And he can't kill my group here.
Oh, I think you're joking.
It looks like he's getting 11th line territory.
Yeah, like,
he's getting center, maybe.
Beautiful.
All right, what would you play here as white? How does white make this worth something? Because so far, if we just look at the score, right, just vaguely, we've got a 5-point corner here, maybe an additional 9 points here. Can't really count anything in here because of the Aji. We'll say this corner is an additional 5. So 19 plus another 5, 24 plus another 5 plus another 3. So 27 plus Komi, so we're about 35, white has about 35 points, reasonably, you know, this part of the game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that's about 35 points right there. Never mind, anything over here. And I'm not even counting this part. So I'm feeling really, really good. Where does white play? What does white have to do to stay in this game?
Capture the black stone.
Or attack, right? Or, like, profit a lot or just capture. Either one. Black will do either one. So what do you play? Whoops, 12-10. This is gonna be pretty. I mean, black can just lean right there, actually.
You can do that.
Looks like, yeah, you're still getting attacked, and black's out. Game. All right, let's get black out. Who wants to play the game? It's a fun game. Let's have black not die today.
Okay.
What do you want to try? Oh, and preferably, we'd like to get black out
and
still attack this.
Keep your 7th line territory.
And keep our 7th. We want to keep 7th line territory, we want to keep the attack on this, and we want to get out. Let's play that game.
Attach right next to that white stone you just put down. To the right.
I think I might make that move myself.
Okay, then what?
Hiding on top.
Oh.
can't really cut. You can cut in either direction. He doesn't care. He's heavy.
Yeah. What if you attach again, right to the right side there?
Hmm?
No, where you were just like, there you go.
This one?
Yeah.
Let's say we cut. Do you connect?
I don't feel good.
But you have to connect. I mean, or your stones are gone.
Connect.
I think they're gone anyway.
Well, white plays here.
And then what if black cuts?
Cuts.
On the left.
Over the top.
Here?
Right there, sure.
Fine.
Yeah.
Now you got to come up with them. That's the.
But if you played the 12-13 first.
This one?
Yeah, if you played that first.
Yeah, don't let him cut you. Right? That's right. Don't let him get that tower cut. No, I'm not.
Well, no, so the sequence you had before with the. Yeah.
Like now?
Okay, let's try.
Like right now?
No, you had another one where you pushed up on top.
Okay. Yeah.
And then you.
Okay.
And now
I want the tower underneath. Preemptively, and then extend. It doesn't work.
Because if you connect, you still get blocked out.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
It doesn't quite work, though, right?
Well.
Kind of, it sort of half works. Sort of half works.
It feels dangerous for white.
Yeah. What if we make this exchange?
Okay. And then, well, you are still okay.
We're still out. We're still out.
You got liberties. You're all right.
Looks like that gets out, sort of. White.
Small stuff.
That's small? This keeps the pressure on. Where do you want to fix?
I want more money. I want to keep my corner.
Well, then it's not small. You just told me it was small. You said this was small. Don't worry about it, right?
No,
then,
I mean... No, well, if it goes solid, he drops. He drops over there. Hmm? Not that one. Yeah,
see,
I was thinking solid, but now I can drop over there. Mm-hmm. Drop that stone over there.
Uh-huh.
Get that horrible move. Which is not that bad.
Mm-hmm. Is it white out now?
It'd be white out. Of course, white's
or black.
The
black
objective was to save your stones.
Do you have eyes yet?
Sorry.
But keep the attack.
Yes. No, keep your top.
This is, first of all, a lot of profit. This is not alive yet. Black needs to continue playing here.
You can play the corner.
I mean, black can live. Like, it's not hard. But this is a pretty big gain. I'm not sure if white can play that move yet.
Sure.
And what about this group? This group? Is this in danger?
No, it's pretty safe now.
It's a lot safer now.
Yeah.
Connect to the lower group.
Yeah.
Yeah, and white has a lot of potential here. I mean, there's defects, to be sure. And, yeah, that got a lot bigger. I don't know if this is, if we just push out, this is good or not. This is not what happened in the game.
It would have been impressive if we guessed that many moves correctly.
You went that one? Well, I'm not saying my sequence in the game was correct either. Like, I have my own regrets about my own sequence. I was just seeing what you guys come up with. See if you guys could find something better than I did.
I don't think that's
not. Oh, yeah.
It sounds like
I'm going to let you guys judge. You guys saw that one, right? White gets a bunch of territory, gets a kind of a crappy wall facing this way, and is 60% safer with this group. I'll say all those things to be kind of true. Here. So the game, my iPad likes to sleep a lot because I played you. And when I play this move, I have to admit, I did kind of misread this. I misread a capturing race, because I looked at this move, right? And this is, in fact, not what happened in the game. So I guess that's the start of my misread. White immediately played here. You hate that? You hate it when your opponent just doesn't do what you ought. You spend so much time reading out the complicated version.
It's like they're trying to do it too. Yeah, I hate the three Blackstones.
You hate it for black, you hate it for white.
Oh, you hate this shape?
Yeah.
This is normally a connected shape.
Yeah, yeah. See, I have a limitation. I've never been able to connect it.
Well, it should always connect. Like, if you just want to connect it, like this is a guaranteed connection, right? Like, these three stones can never be split, right? They're all connected. But if I just play this, it's not the game. Look, right? I connected them all.
Yay.
What's the problem?
You don't even have an eye
wall. I should be there, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, that's not so good. But they're connected, right? You have to give me that.
I'll give you that.
All right. White played here, which was a surprise to me, actually. I should have spent more time reading this. Like, I just thought this wasn't even feasible. But it totally is, it turns out. So I played here. Part of my misread is also here. Like, I thought this worked a lot better for me than it did, because I thought it put a lot more pressure on this group. But white connects here first. And do you guys see what this move does?
Obviously
it disconnects from, it prevents me from cutting out. But the part that I failed to realize, I think, you know, about five moves ago before this whole sequence played, is how short my liberties are.
Right.
Yeah.
In this case. I guess I realized it, but I just didn't want to admit it to myself, you know, kind of thing. I can fight. I'm doing so well. Look at how much I'm winning by. I can't lose a fight.
Well, let's try the sequence.
What do you want? Do you have an idea of what you want to try, or you just
want to... Give him his first move that you didn't see. Okay, let's...
explore some options
now,
here.
Okay, now experimentally, let's cut that one stone off. But we're not going to extend that other stone.
Okay.
Okay, now let's jump away.
Jump away?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, am I just... Okay, now let's cut. No. Just back. Yeah. Okay, now let's get our forcing. We have forcing. Now I'll take your forcing. Yeah. Okay, keep going.
Presuming you want this one?
Yeah.
I think this is very single-minded here, because this is...
Yeah,
even if I get out.
Hold on.
Okay.
80 points.
Okay, now...
Now, if you capture that white...
I have to play this now, right? I don't think there's any more pushing. I think pushing time is over.
Let's see if we actually have to play it.
Oh, I think you do. I think pushing time is over. Okay. I think this is a really terrible result for black. Okay.
Dan, don't direct discussion. Oh,
this is garbage now, right?
Who's moving?
Well, it's blacks, right? We can try something like this, but,
yeah, but you do a few
too many liberties, right? It's 3-3.
Yeah.
White's move. And meanwhile, white got, I mean, granted there's free Ataris over here, I now have a new weak group to worry about. But I don't think this is playable. I don't think this is playable.
Okay, try capturing
the one. No, we're going back to the game. We're going back. All right. So, just to refresh. Oops. This was my surprise. There shouldn't have been a surprise. Again, I was fully expecting White to do this. Wait, is that right? Hold on. This is there. There we go. And so when I extend here, I get out, sort of. Oh, sorry, that's not the move. At this point, after I jump here, white plays this move.
Ooh.
What does this do?
That hurts. Separates now. That separates.
Well, I can sort of. I mean, I can capture that stone.
But
if I do,
it's not going to do you much good.
I'm super dead, right?
Yeah.
Because now white can actually push through here in Atari, right? It shorts my liberties. So this is a really nice throw-in by white, right? This takes away the liberties. And now all of a sudden, after white plays this, I have to come back and play that. And white played this one to be extra safe. This one's a little dangerous, right?
Why is that one more dangerous?
Maybe it's not that much dangerous. Just because it's leaving me with more liberties here.
Oh.
No immediate capture.
But I don't think it matters. So.
Either way.
I think white should have played. I think this is a small mistake. But it's very small. Alright, so I want to say the fight is sort of over, and these are still going to be attacked, or can be attacked. What did black get out of this whole thing? Starting with.
7 flying points.
Hmm?
7 flying points.
Yeah, something like 7th line territory.
Mm-hmm.
I did pick up an extra stone over here, right? So, I mean, don't underestimate that. I did get that as well. What did white get?
We got a nice, little, secure, strong group now with it's unattackable, unassailable.
Yeah, so now white has strength here. These two stones are kind of garbagey right now, but they're still useful as long as this is weak and this is weak. So they're not that weak either. How about this? That's just 10 points pure profit. It's not 7th line kind of profit, but, you know, that's strength, right? That clears up all possibilities. And because I had taken this cut earlier, right, normally black would have good endgame over here, right? Because if black wants to block, I get this extra Atari in. All right, so I get all these free moves. But because I had made this exchange, I don't even get that anymore. So, I mean, white's result is actually, in the end, pretty reasonable. I play here, which I don't think anybody likes this move.
I like it, which doesn't represent a good thing.
Well, I'll
not a ring.
It's not a vote of confidence.
Right.
The fact that George likes it. All right. Well, how about you guys? Because you know, you guys can all relate to this move somehow. What is white saying to white? Or what is black saying to white with this kind of move?
I don't know, sort of like,
basically, you're not going to get saying, I don't need to worry about that anymore, it's over.
I'm getting territory.
Yeah, I'm just going to take a big point. You know, I know there's still a bunch of crap in here, but I'm just not going to worry about it.
Yeah.
Right? I don't feel like dealing with this. Maybe this stone will help us use it later on.
I'm going out for a smoke.
Yeah, I'm just going to go over here and play a big point. I think it's a bad idea. I'm pretty sure it's a bad idea. I'm still not really sure where I play, though. I mean, this is really weak now, because it's not because white's so strong here. Like, it's still a really big move, but it's not doesn't have nearly the same sente connotations it once did. Of course, playing over here and just trying to seal this off is also really big. Coming down here is possible, too, but again, it has the same kind of feeling as this. And this group is still weak, so I mean, most proper is probably something like this, to be fair, but even then, right, there's still sort of co-shapes for white in the corner. So I don't really want to play that either.
I don't really hate the move you did make, though. I think that's all.
But it's like here's the thing. Like this is I don't know where to play, right? And I this is where like I need like someone who's really stronger than me, like you know 4 or 5 stones stronger than me, to look at this and go, oh, yeah, you play here. I don't know if that's the move or not, but I'm betting it's not. But it's probably something in here, right? It's probably you know here.
Hey, right there's
what
no
about
bad.
That, I mean, it's kind of loose dead. I don't know what you can get out of it. I can't read that far quickly.
Well, white can get out, right?
Right.
So, but it's...
Get out of...
Yeah, I think Tanuki is okay.
I don't think this is good.
I would have made that like a card. Like
can
card
white get out of that?
Yeah.
If you have the stone?
No,
stone?
Yeah,
the car was...
Like, yes, too many
these
ones.
Yeah.
Oh,
and
then...
Kind of,
yeah,
what about the looser net,
yeah.
Though? 10, 13.
10, 13 here. This one?
Yeah.
Weiser's out.
Well, he is, but he still has some too many Augies.
Yeah, there's Augie I can or you know, maybe this is better. I don't know. But it's probably that move, right? I mean, stronger player will probably come here and say, oh, you should play that move. And maybe just try to sacrifice these in the most creative way possible. But whatever it is, it's not that move. This is like, I'm going to take a big point, you deal with this. Which is probably the wrong way to play Go. But sometimes it works, you know? Sometimes you have no idea what to do in a situation, and it's above your level, and you're just like, you know, if I can't figure it out, I bet my opponent can't either. So let's just go play a big point, and, you know, game on. Sometimes your opponent will call you on it and find the right point. All right, white did something very, very interesting here. White played here. White was thinking the exact same lines as I was, right? Don't know what to do here. Let's go mess around in here.
It's a creative situation.
And I'm still thinking, hey, I've got seventh line territory. I've got my corner. Hey, I've basically, you know, just about saved my last weak group here. I don't need to do anything too drastic. I can just sort of hem this in. And what was the move? Right there? Yep.
Really?
Well, why not?
That's what I was thinking. Because it's just I
want
to go away from two different
attacking
stones.
Above and below.
I can totally now completely seal, you know, rule this part of the board. It helps out this group. It keeps pressure on this stone. It does a lot of things kind of mediocre.
Yeah, also, you're putting a lot of
faith
into the
fact
that you're really going to keep that full top of the board.
Well, I would almost agree with you, except these moves, I'm also trying to be very conscious of not giving white anything else to build out here.
Right.
These moves are not, if I just wanted this side of the board, right, I should be playing that move.
Yeah, but the problem is, if you got a Hoshi stone on the bottom right there, and so there's a lot of stuff there. And meanwhile, he can threaten.
But imagine a situation where white gets sealed in, lives in Gotei here. And I can come out of this with this group safe, my corner solidified, and a wall over here?
Sure.
Would you say that's not a good...
That's not...
Okay, well, here, guess what happened in the game?
It's happened. Oh! You play like this.
Yes.
Did you get the corner, though?
If you wait three moves, Dan, you'll see the answer. This clamp may or may not have been a good idea.
I think this works.
Yeah, the clamp is probably a little bit of an overplay, which I call him on it immediately, but there's still Augie in here, so maybe. And how about that?
That's better.
I mean, to solidify this corner, now basically really splitting up this side of the board. These two stones have no friends to run to, right? I mean, the closest friend is here. Second closest is maybe there. So, I don't know. It feels like white's very busy and doesn't have time to actually come back and deal with this.
So...
plays here. Takes another corner. In this case, I just connect because again, I'm still saying, "Hey, I've got Augie over here." You know, you've got. If you play over here, that's fine. I'm just going to seal you in and make all this into points. Right? White doesn't want that, so white plays here. I make one exchange right now, which I think white just connects.
He did that.
White could do this. That might be a hair stronger.
Yeah.
This is a little bit of a minus for white. And then we come over here.
So he
just defends, right? I mean, this is. I mean, if he tries anything, this is pretty tough. So he just fixes first. And so I just go after this one stone. If white is going to run, first of all, white should read this out more. And there is a forcing kind of move like this to actually give white some shape, but white doesn't take it. So white just comes out. And this is fine. I'm not really sure where white's running to yet. Do you guys know where white's running to?
There's the two friends in the middle.
Yeah, well, he says, I want to run there. And I go, that's awesome. Great. Just split. And he says, oh, by the way, I want to run there.
Somebody just said that.
That's the next move.
So you want this.
And I go, that's fine. You can have it. So this was white side of the board, right?
Boy, wow.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you
want. So let's look at territory. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31-ish. So about 67 points for white. Okay. Let's look at black. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48. About 100 points for black. I mean, if this stands, right? Oh, I didn't give white this. I should give white that. So maybe it's probably more like a 25-30 point game, at least in my head at this point. But white plays here. And white goes, all right, I'm down by how many ever points it is. Let's
can't
go.
Lose any worse.
Let's go. And so I'm going, hey, I'm up by 25 points. I'll just play defensive. So white hanes. And I even say, okay, that's fine. You can have a honey. And white says, I would like a two-space base. And at this point, I should probably have just either played here or here, or basically anything other than what I did. It's one of those moments. I just go, where you're just, yeah. You can't live in there. I'm just going to make sure you can't run out. And the other thing I was worried about when I played this move, I was still sort of eyeing this Aji. Right? He has a free Atari here, and maybe that gives him another free move. And I was like, there might be potential, actually, for him to make an eye up here. So I played this move. But the problem with this move is that it immediately gets to fix the connection and make eye shape. So this was probably a pretty train wreck kind of a move. I mean, in order for me to play two really slow moves over here, if you're going to invest two really slow moves, your next move has to be aggressive, right? You can't play another slow move. You play three slow moves in a row, you're gone. So white plays here, and I go, oh, fine, we'll play co. Of course, starts co, and we take the co, and white has a million threats because, hey, I was up by 30 points, right? So white's going to have all the threats. So we play here, and then white plays co, and I just fill, and white pushes out, right? I'm just being really defensive. I'm just saying, you know, I'm up by too many points. There's not enough space left on this board for you to win.
There, you won't be up by too many points.
This is true. So white takes all the free stuff, and then comes back here, and that's alive. So that feels pretty terrible. And Ollie's alive. This group actually has a potential to be cut later, too.
Was there a reason that you extended right there, that
here?
Last move, instead of just capturing that one white stone?
Yeah, because I'm trying not to give white another free move.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
Although, actually, in the end, that's probably the better thing to do, Gideon.
Huh?
But I don't know. Actually, well, then it, I don't know. It gives white more shape out. But remember how I said white could get an eye over here? Mm. Totally going to do that and eat my stone. I don't know. I haven't thought about this part of the game too closely. Because I was just sad.
I'm just curious.
I was just sad.
You didn't even make me sadder.
That's not there yet. That's like that. And I block, and this keeps a little bit of pressure on. White plays a couple funny shape moves in here. I do get to get a little bit of a... I wouldn't even call it free stuff, because White's is happy he's not dead. Oh, sorry, White plays there. And White peeps here. Which is kind of a thing, right? This cow is still kind of available, right? In the back of our minds, after all these moves, we're just sort of shape fighting, we're hand fighting, because there is this co which can cut off this group. If white has to connect out here. So white does more hand fighting. And I participate as well, right? He's really just trying to harass this thing, right? He'd really love it if I had to come back and take an extra stone off the board. Turn. And,
Wouldn't you love it just as much as if he captured those two stones?
Oh, did I miss a move? I missed a move, sorry. I'm not sure when I missed it. Oh, this is the wrong shape. Oh, what's going on here? Oh my gosh.
Oh, you didn't fix it back from when I asked the question, I think.
Gideon, I blame you.
That's fair.
Sorry, that is the shape. That is the shape. Yeah, so I poke in here because I don't want to ever have to connect this. Right, so if I can get this move, white can never connect. But of course, white also knows that, so he takes that, but then it lets me get this shape. So he has to take this. And then I'm just playing all this stuff just to harass this group down to nothing, right? This is just, you know, hand fighting. Again, I'm threatening a ko here. So white fills, which activates this stone directly. But then again, we have this kind of thing. So white has guaranteed two eyes. All right. So now how does this game look for black?
Less good.
Well, all those points I kind of was counting on.
They're gone.
They're gone. So now it's a game.
At this point, I'd probably take the 9-3 right there.
Oh, you want to start this code right now? Remember, it's only a co.
But if you do that one, right, where's white going to go next? Is he going to take the co?
Yeah, I think white can take the co here.
Okay, so
If white doesn't, white can also start looking at, playing moves out here that threaten to get the stones out other ways. I'm not convinced the co is big enough yet, quite honestly, is why I don't start it. I'm still convinced there's actually bigger moves on the board.
Because if white takes the co right there, mm-hmm. and you play at 8 just below white right there.
Yeah. Yeah, eat one stone.
Oh.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna leave my stone there. It's essentially a free move, right? Forcing white to connect. And that's when I come back and I decide to get these out. Remember? Because white wanted these too. And since I already got all this, wouldn't it be cool if I got, you know, some more stuff in here? That'd be cool. And then we play endgame. And all right, I'm actually going to say that most of the rest of the game is the end game, except for white had a chance to win. I'm gonna skip a few end game moves in this area. White had a really good chance to win, and I should have lost this game. I did in fact win, but after I played here, white played it here, which for whatever reason, I didn't see this cut as being viable, but it totally works. I guess we do need a couple more moves in here to see that this worked. All right, I don't care enough to show you, but I almost lost it, and I should have lost it because white could have actually cut that back off. Yeah, I didn't. I wasn't paying attention. I was too focused on the full fighting in here. So in the end, black wins by 3.5 points.
Whoa.
Not a very proud win. But, you know, a lot of it, like I said, a few things went wrong. Number one, I think a good way to beat me is to make me feel like I'm winning. Right, I lose a lot of games that way. The other thing that happened, right, so I told you guys about the Byo-Yomi thing. Like, I didn't realize I was in my last Byo-Yomi, like, until I was there. So that kind of freaked me out a little bit, too. So a lot of my moves, I mean, White would come and invade these areas, and I'd play very, very soft moves. Like, very, very defensive. Let's just take points. Let's just not ruin our shape. Let's just make sure, you know, White can't get out. These very, very soft moves, rather than actually taking the time to read, you know, these longer fighting sequences. So I feel bad. I mean, this game makes me feel bad as a Go player.
His victory is still simply Pyrrhic. He won on the board.
I know, but it makes me feel worse that I should have lost because I played this too carelessly in the end, too. But again, I was in my last 30-second Byo-Yomi, and the thing is going beep, beep. It was like a bomb.
What would you have rather lost that one?
It's tough to say. You know, sometimes, you know, you need to lose a game. I mean, superficially, I think I'm glad I won. But I still feel bad. This should have gotten cut off.